Welcome to our webinar today. Wonderful to have you guys on the call. We're Karen and I are really excited to have you here. This is a really, really special day for us because we get the opportunity to share with you guys that that we've learned, that we've seen on this journey around creating change, around having fulfillment in our lives, this journey around feeling good and helping other people do it. So really, really excited to have you on the call and welcome to everyone. I'm here with my colleague, Karen.
Hi, everyone. It's great to be here. As Fiona was saying, we were extremely excited to be here today, and we are extremely excited and to put together all these things to share with you. So thank you very much for taking the time. Being here. And if you want to say hi, we have a chat box that you should see at the right. So you have the option of making your comments public or private. So please feel free to say hello. And I think that we are on time. And why wouldn't we start checking, Fiona, with people why they are here? What calls their attention to be here?
Yeah, sure.
And also,
yeah, I think that's also
what they would like to take out of this webinar as well. So we make it really productive and worthwhile for everyone.
Yeah, sure. A great question. You know, why is it? I'll just take a moment, you know, to really reflect on that. What is it that brought you here? What is it that you're looking for from today? What would you like to get from this session? I think it's a really, really important question. And we'd love to know if you're happy to share it. What it is that brought you here? What is it that calls you around what we're talking about? Because I'm presuming that you've had a chance to watch the videos that we sent you through. What is it that brought you here, and what would you like to get from today?
How about we start with those comments that you can see there, Fiona? We have Anne, Mark saying hi and commenting as well.
Yeah, okay, thanks. So Anne's saying that, so Anne's saying that for her, it was what really called her was looking for another way that she could really relate to what we were saying around that the feeling as though you've constantly got to fix yourself. And she'd love to look for a different way of seeing that or approaching that, because she has, yeah, she could really relate to that in what we were talking about. Yeah, nice one, Anne. Good.
I relate with that. Lovely. You know, there's a point when we realize, you know what, how about if, what if it's not, the pushing is not so necessary? And I think that that's what I was after for a long time, you know. How about if there's another option and I'm just looking in a misleading direction? And look, I like also what Mark's saying here, that is, that's quite common, Mark, that, you know, after that, we love coaching, we love helping people, we want to have a better life for ourselves, but we find ourselves stuck, not being able to know or to take the next step. And that's part of what we are going to talk today, why that happened. And why that happens so much in the coaching world, you know, because it looks like we have so many tools, so many, you know, theories and things, and still many, many coaches or many people who want to use coaching, could be for, you know, to become coaches or just to use coaching in their own life, why they feel so stuck. It's so many tools and they feel even worse. So we're going to explore that as well.
Mark. Definitely, that's a big one for sure.
Yeah, you want to talk about a comment here from Jean? Jean, I don't know, Jean.
Jean. Yeah, look, Jean's saying that what she's really looking for is consistency in how she feels. That it feels very up and down. Like, is that right, Jean? Am I getting what you're saying correctly?
I think that you used to. You are gonna have to use your headset because we are getting some noise coming from you, and people are having issues listening to you.
Okay, I'll get that. You finish off Jean's comment while I get my headset.
Okay, cool. So I think that consistency is something quite interesting, Jean, because I think that one of the biggest issues that we have around this industry, around coaching and self-development and all that, we start believing in certain standards. So we start believing in certain standards, and one of the biggest cause for the roller coaster in the way that we feel is not so much what is happening with us, more than all that comparison that is happening between, you know, this is the way that I feel versus this is the way that I should be feeling. This is what I want out of life, but this is what I should be doing out of my life. So there is a lot of noise that is creating all that ups and downs. And we're gonna talk about that as well, you know, that why we feel so self-conscious, why we feel so insecure, why we feel that we have to be so different than what we are. We're gonna talk about that as well. Okay, so I think that we could keep going, Fiona, if you want. We can start with what we have prepared. But thank you for the comments, and we are reading all the comments, the publics and the private ones. So keep them coming. So let's talk about why we are doing this, why we are putting the time and like Fiona and I, we have two different type of businesses. We have been able to make a living out of coaching in many different ways. And fortunately, we have been able to do what we love doing. So why start doing this, and why in this moment? And I think that first of all is because we found something that is so different than what many people get taught, that it was so different than what we got taught around, you know, what we were trained for. And because as you probably heard from our story, from the previous videos, I think that if we wouldn't find what we found, I don't know if we will still be here. I don't know if you're probably, you know, I'm talking about hypothetically, that's what you say. I don't know if it's worth it, but I think that at some point we would have said, you know what, this is too hard. We are not made for this. Let's try something else. So why are we doing this?
Well, you know, I know for me, one of the things that always called me was that, you know, I always had the intention of really wanting to make a difference in helping people. I that was such a strong burning need in me that it was a voice inside me that just grew stronger and stronger and stronger over time. And so, you know, I was so, I for me, ending suffering, people's suffering, and helping people in their suffering has been a huge driver. And so I really wanted to know, and I was looking for ways on how I could do that effectively, how I could really make that happen for people. It was this burning, burning, burning need. Now, I know a lot of people have can relate to that. A lot of people who want to be coaches feel the same way, and that it's one of the things that drives us. And for me, definitely knowing how to do that consistently, how to do that well, what has been of the utmost importance in my journey.
So yeah, I agree with Fiona that my reason of why getting into coaching But as I said before, I think that it was yes, I wanted to make a difference. Yes, I wanted something that inspired me because I was in a career that, even though it was what I was supposed to be doing, I didn't feel fulfilled. And but what really I think moved me was the fact that I got so used to feel bad about myself, bad about life, inadequate. I was diagnosed with chronic depression. I was medicated for chronic depression, and I have tried so many things. I have tried all type of therapies, you know, the most scientific things and the least scientific things, trying to find answers, trying to find, okay, what's wrong with me? And I think that not even what was wrong with me, because I think that I had a clear picture, what I thought it was a clear picture of what was wrong with me. You know, I'm insecure, I'm not special, I'm not enough, I'm not smart enough, I'm not pretty, I'm not this, I'm not that, this happened to me, this damaged me, this hurt me, this left a mark on me, blah, 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 blah. So I was clearly what was wrong. But it didn't matter what I tried to solve that, to move on from that, to, you know, I went back to the same place. So I was desperate to find an answer. And the answer that I was after is, how can I feel good about myself? How can I, you know, I was looking at other people and everyone looked like happy and they have their life together. And I was feeling, my feeling was that I was drowning, trying to survive life. But something in me was saying, you know what? That was a good thing. That's what probably kept me alive. That I had the hope of finding how can I feel good about myself. That I could have a purpose. That I could enjoy life, right? And in that became an obsession because I saw it as an antidote to how crap I feel about myself. And in that search, I found coaching. Right, with the big promise of, you know, this is gonna solve all your issues. Plus, you can make heaps of money doing it. So for me, it was like, right, this is my thing. And now that changed my life, because also the first path that I took around coaching has taken me here. So that was the opening door, and. And I think that this is a good point that we were asking why you were in this webinar and what you wanted to take out of this webinar. But also, I would love to invite everyone on the line to just to reflect for a moment, because I know that most of you are here because you are interested in coaching. You are even if it's to become a coach because you are already a coach, or because you want more in your life and you want to use the coaching for that. So what is that you're after? Right? Because with that in mind, what we are going to share with you is what's happening in the coaching field, in terms of the coaching field is getting more specialized. And, you know, everyone is coming with the latest model, the latest technique, the latest blah, blah, blah. About how to create this magic in the world. So if that's true, how come we are not experiencing more of what we want? So there are misunderstandings. And we're not saying anything against anyone. We are just saying that with the best intention, we are still, you know, spinning around, chasing our tail, trying to create that well-being. So we are gonna share with you one of the core misunderstandings that is causing all that if you build from taking as a foundation a misunderstanding, you're gonna keep spinning, right? Mm-hmm. This is not about, oh, we're gonna promise you how to make $1 million in the next blah blah blah. We are gonna promise. It's not about that, because I think that until we feel the well-being that we are meant to feel, until we explore our own greatness, until we are that comfortable in our own skin. The money, the thing, the promise around this, they are meaningless. You know, we always say, the moment that I have this amount of clients, the moment that we have this amount of money, the moment that, no, that's using the same paradigm. It's possible to experience well-being, flow, fulfillment, but not if we keep the same foundation, the misunderstandings as a foundation, right? So we are gonna share with you how to have this a solid foundation where you can build for whatever you want to use coaching for, right? And we are gonna share with you as well how to take this to the next level. So for those of you who are interested to explore deeper, Fiona and I, we have put something together that we want to share with those of you who want to say, want to explore this and say, you know what? I want to go deeper. I'm feeling something here. Something here is resonating, right? So that's what we are gonna cover. And probably our first invitation is for you to relax and listening to this as a piece of music. This is not something that you need to make notes and analyze about, because the intellect, what we think we know, what we have learned, what we have heard, is gonna get in your way of really feeling this, of really getting this. And this is not something that you're gonna get with your intellect. It could make sense, but something bigger is gonna resonate. So you just relax and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, thanks, Karen. You know, I think what you were saying, that, you know, if we're following on from that intention of looking for answers and wanting to help people, and I know that, you know, if you're on this call, that that is something that resonates with you. You know, when you and I were looking for those answers and wanting to help people, that's how we found ourselves in the world of coaching and personal development. And as a part of that, we found ourselves, you know, acquiring a lot of information, a lot of theory, a lot of models on how to do things, a lot of learnings or understandings that were based on techniques. And then as part of that, we also started to learn that there were a lot of rules and standards around what success looks like. Okay, how we need to conduct ourselves if we want to be successful, the things that the rituals that we need to do on a daily basis, and that, you know, it's all about you really having the commitment to be able to continuously work on yourself, have the discipline to follow through on those rituals every day, to implement, to study, to push, to keep digging, peeling back your layers, all of that stuff, right? And what happens when you live from that paradigm, and that's certainly what Karen and I experienced, and I'd be really curious to know if you yourself have experienced that, is you start second guessing yourself a little bit, because you know, there are days where you don't want to do all of that, where you don't feel motivated or driven to, where you feel tired, where you're struggling. And then you say, well, I'm obviously not committed enough. Mm. I'm not following through on all of those things. There must be something wrong with me. I must need more help. I, you know, I've got to be like that person that follows through, that does this, that does that. And you end up comparing yourself, finding yourself inadequate based on that comparison. You end up second guessing the progress that you're making, you second guess your abilities, and the first time that the things that you've been taught don't quite land, then you say to yourself, it must be me. Mm. It's because I'm not motivated enough. I haven't followed through on my rituals. I haven't done my hour of power for the last 2 days. That's why. And I'm not on top of things. So, you know, I've got to push. I've got to be on top of things. I've got to get myself more motivated. I've got to really be a lot more committed than I am. And so you find yourself quite innocently, and I use the term unwittingly because I didn't see this at first, you find yourself in this paradigm of needing to push, to pump yourself up, to be motivated, to be positively thinking all of the time, to implement rituals just so you can keep your head above water. Mm. Now, I'm just wondering, is this sounding familiar to anybody on the call?
It does to me a lot.
It does?
Because it's true, you know, and the issue is that we believe that that's the answer. So the problem is not what we are doing, is that we are not doing it enough, or we are not doing it correctly. And because we are so indoctrinated on that, it's like, come on, improve yourself. What's the best version of yourself? Give the most, the extra mile, blah, blah, blah. Which in itself, it does nothing wrong. It's just that we believe that that's the solution for the way that we feel. And that's when the misunderstanding starts, you know? And all this coaching and all these techniques and models, they become another thing that we need to pump ourselves with, you know? And I was telling Fiona, one of the things that, and by the way, I apologize for my English. You're going to hear not only my accent, but that I'm going to make a lot of mistakes in my English. I'm improving. I'm doing my best. I was telling Fiona that one of the most looked after in this industry, when I had the opportunity to have a conversation with him, and I said, you're still doing that ritual, an X type of ritual, and he said, yeah, because the day that I don't, I get depressed. Mm-hmm. And I said, so he's coaching about. And all these things about, you know, finding the right ritual so you get distracted. So you get, you know, it's like an injection. It's like another thing that you have to keep going, because is that what it's all about? And I remember that. And this is when I was, I don't know how many years into this. And I felt it like that. It's like we are using coaching and all that as other people use alcohol, or other people use, you know, like saving proportions, but that there is something that is not quite okay, because we are not understanding what is really happening. And one of the issues is that if you hear that around, improve yourself, be the best version of yourself, go the extra mile, you know, and then you hear, oh yes, this is because you need to clear your past, you need to let go of these memories, you need to change this about yourself. Some people say focus on your strengths. Other people say focus on your weaknesses. Other people say you have to have a very clear vision. You have to have this type of goals. You need to do all blah, blah, blah. All that sound, you know, it makes a lot of sense. The intellect says, oh, yeah, I have the theory. I need this. I need that. Oh, yeah. So we feel like, okay, we are in the right path. But why many of those things? How many of us haven't tried really hard doing all those things? How many of us, we have met people that are doing all those things? And it's like they're in surviving mode. Why? What is the missing link, the missing piece that we are not taking into account? So we have to try so hard. We have to manufacture ourselves, mm-hmm. manufacture well-being, manufacture greatness. Is that the way it's supposed to be doing? Now, if that is not working for us, you know, it's because we are so damaged, it's because we are lazy, it's because we are mediocre. I don't think so. I think that many people would say the problem is you need to be more, you know, but I think that is when we have the wrong information. It's like if someone sells you a map, you know, a very expensive, very, you know, with all the details and the latest technology and the blah, blah, blah. He said, you need to use this map to get here. But if the map is wrong, doesn't matter how much you try, doesn't matter how much you invest, it doesn't matter how much willpower, you're not going to get where you need to get, because the map doesn't work. And I think that it's time that in the industry of coaching, we start reevaluating things. How come there are so many people involved in this industry and so little results? You know, or we have some results. Like I had results, Fiona got results. But how come they are so expensive in terms of energy, time, effort, and money? And why they don't last? Why we have to keep pumping? You know? So one of the things is that we assume that the answer that we are after, which is how we feel about ourselves, how we explore these inner resources, we are looking for them outside, in my achievements, in my relationships, in the things that I have. And then it comes the be, do, have model. What do you need to do in order to have what you are? And the premise of all that is what? You need to be someone that you are not. Otherwise, why you even ask that question, who do you need to be? So you are not being the person that you need to be. There is something in your being that you need to manufacture, that you need to create, that you need. And coming from where are you going to do this? Coming from a bunch of ideas, a bunch of standards that we don't even see. We are so used to believe all that about ourselves that we don't see that what we are doing is using ideas, standards, rules, and so on to define who do we need to be, and then who are not being. And then it's, okay, so in that sense, I need all this, and then I need to do this in order to have this, and then we start spinning around based on a lot of ideas, a bunch of beliefs, and a lot of, right? And then we start matching, oh, this is a match of this? No, so I need to fix myself more. I need to improve myself. And then we do the same thing with our clients.
Yes, that's exactly right. And I love what you just said. And then we do the same things with our clients. And you know what's really interesting about that is, like, if we feel that way, imagine how our clients must feel, right? Mm-hmm. Except they're a lot more vulnerable because, you know, they truly believe that there's something wrong with them. They truly believe they need fixing, that they're broken in some way. And then we come in with, no, look, you're not really broken, but you need to do this, 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 and this, and then you'll be okay, right? And it's a really, really interesting paradigm.
I'm sorry, because something that I couldn't resist myself. And, you know, in many of the coaching trainings, they said, yes, the answer is inside of you. You have everything you need within yourself now. But you need to read this script in order to access it. But you need to do all this in order to. So I said, if I have the answers, how come I need all this? I need all these techniques, all these analysis, all these things, all these complex things. Yeah, sorry, keep going, because that sounds, you know, we can see it from a little bit of distance. Yeah, what happened with I have everything I need within me now until I fix this and after I do this and after I learn this? Yeah.
Yeah, so it's a little contradictory, you know, and when we started, we didn't see that. We thought, okay, well, that makes sense. You know, we're learning, we're here to learn, we want to make a difference. Of course we need to learn stuff. Right. So, and there is an element of truth in that. There are things you need to learn, but there was so much information, so many things. And it was just every time something wasn't quite flowing, we were led to believe that we just need more information. Right. And this, I think, is at the basis of so many misunderstandings for us. When it comes to this constant need to have to improve ourselves, to know more, to be more, to do more, etc., right? And if you look at where these things come from, why we're saying all of this is a misunderstanding, is because if you look around at the actual validity of these things that we accept as truth, and that Karen and I used to accept as truth, that we just blindly go, okay, well, it makes sense. If you want to be happier, of course you've got to do more. Of course you've got to be more. Of course you've got to work hard. I mean, I grew up with that drummed into me that people who work hard get rewarded. And then if you're not working hard enough, then you don't deserve to be rewarded. Yeah. So, you know, it's everywhere around us, culturally, socially. These are what is considered normal. Now, it doesn't make them healthy and it doesn't make them true, but they are common. So we see them as normal and we blindly accept them. Now, when we blindly accept them, so do our clients. And what happens is you find yourself on this never-ending ride. And that was certainly my experience, and I know it was Karen's experience, and we've certainly spoken to other coaches who've experienced this sense of being on this treadmill of, you know, consistently needing to improve yourself, to be the best version of you. Now, if I hear that one more time, I've just got to be the best version of me. I'm like, it implies something. It implies that the best version of you is not there right now. It implies that you're missing something, right? So you're constantly living out of a paradigm that there's something missing. I've got to do this to be the best version of me. Now, what people don't realize is you're continually telling yourself there's something missing, and that instead of living out of the paradigm of the best version of you, you're living out of the paradigm of the fact that the best version of me is kind of this thing that I'll get to one day. If I try hard enough, if I work hard enough, if I'm committed and I apply myself. And, you know, I started to, and Karen and I definitely, you know, really started to question the truth of this. It's like, are we really meant to be working this hard on ourselves? Is the ability to feel good meant to take so much work and effort? Is that really true? And we started to really sit in that space and reflect on it, because if you look around you, there is evidence to suggest not when you know where to look. And, you know, we started to say, is this true, or is it simply that we just think it's true? Yeah. And because we think it's true, we accept it's true. And now I'm going to say that again, because some of you may have gone, what did you just say? You know, simply because we think something is true does not make it truth. It really does not. You know, we are conditioned to believe every single thing we think. We are conditioned to believe that. We are conditioned to take notice of everything we think. We're conditioned to believe that truth comes from what we think. Now, the problem with that is we think an awful lot about an awful lot of things, right? And if you've ever worked with clients, you know, one of the most common things that clients will come to you with is, I'm stuck. I can't stop thinking about this thing. And I've thought and thought and thought and thought and thought and thought and thought about it, and I'm stuck. And I'm in my head and I'm analyzing it, and I can't seem to get an answer. And the more I think, the less I feel the answer's there. And I don't know what to do. I've tried this, I've thought about that, right? And they're in this cycle, like this thought treadmill that they don't know how to get off of. Now, if you're conditioned to believe that every single thing you think is true, then it's quite understandable that you're going to end up there, why people do get stuck. Now, if you then combine the fact that we're conditioned to believe that everything is true with the fact that we're also conditioned to believe that we're damaged in some way, that there's something not right with us that we need to fix. And if you've had something happen to you in your past, something traumatic, then absolutely that means you're damaged. Right? It's everywhere around us that, you know, if someone has experienced trauma, then of course they're going to have problems. So, you know, we are innocently being fed this paradigm that, yes, you know, you've got to believe everything you think, you've got to take notice of it and what you think is truth, and also that feeling good requires work. Feeling good is something that you have to manage. It's not something that comes naturally. It's not something that that everybody has. It's really only reserved for those who are prepared to put in the work. And it's really, really interesting when you sit and think about it. And this is a space that Karen and I spent quite a bit of time sitting in, because, you know, we had spent all this time, all this effort, all this money on improving ourselves. And we, at the end of the day, we didn't actually feel all that different. We'd had some change, but it wasn't consistent. It was very fluctuating. And we were noticing this occurring with our clients. And we both were feeling the same way. There's something missing, right? So, you know, if you think about all the things that we assume to be true, and if you then think about what it is that we think we are versus what we actually are, you start to come up with some very interesting insights around that. And what you start to see is that it is true that we feel differently about ourselves from time to time. It is true that you can have days where everything looks clear, you feel on top of the world, you've got all this confidence, this drive, you feel inspired, motivated, you're ready to go. And the next day, you can feel as though you're at ground zero again. And it is a fluctuating thing. You know, the fact that we feel different constantly. How come it fluctuates like that? And how come it can fluctuate so enormously, where you can feel on top of the world one day and at the bottom the next? And where you can feel really inspired and motivated one day, and the next day I can't even be bothered getting out of bed. Right? And then, of course, there's all the other fluctuations in between. I'm giving you the extremes, but there's also everything else in between there. And, you know, and the thing is, the thing that we don't really take into account is the commonality is this is a fluctuating thing for everybody without exception. And the reason that it's fluctuating is because it's our thinking that fluctuates. It's our thinking that changes. That's the common thing with all humans. That's why the fluctuation of feelings is a common thing, because everybody has fluctuating thinking. And if you were to take that a step further, you start to realize, and this is where what Karen and I discovered that made such a huge impact on us, is that how we feel, how we experience the world is a direct result of what we think. And what we think is varying constantly, right? It's transient, it's changing all of the time. And most of the time we're not even aware of it. And we innocently get caught up thinking that our reality, that what we're feeling comes from something else, that circumstance, that thing, the trauma that happened in the past. And we don't realize that it's actually coming. Every single feeling we have is coming from what we're actually thinking about in that moment. And so the fluctuation that you're experiencing, that everybody experiencing, is a direct result of the thinking that you're having, of the change of thought that's taking place inside everybody constantly.
I think that's and this is something that we would love for you to let sink for a moment. For two reasons. First, just let it in without going to the next step, because any of us as coaches, we're just trying to think, that's why we have to think positively, that's why you have to use this in order to manipulate your thinking. No, we are not talking about that. We are just pointing to the fact of the way that we create our moment by moment experience of life comes from our thinking. And the only thing that we can experience in life is our thinking. We just want to establish that as a fact, not that you have to do anything about it, because the way that we have been trained is gonna get in the way. So just the fact that we live in the experience of our thinking, right? And this is quite interesting because it's like if I'm experiencing a nightmare, you know, if I'm experiencing a nightmare, what all the traditional coaching, all the traditional techniques, therapies, blah, 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 would go and say, ah, let's make that dream a better one. Let's fix what you are dreaming about. So let's try to make it positive, beautiful. Let's try for you to get over this situation that is happening in your dream. Because you're feeling that, what happened when we are dreaming? We feel that that is happening. We feel that as is real, that we're experiencing that, all the full of the full, it's like reality. It feels like that, right? We're experiencing that in fullness. And all the techniques try to fix what you're dreaming, what we are saying, stop doing that, because it's not gonna last. You just need to realize that you're dreaming. You just need to look in the direction that you are dreaming. And eventually you're gonna wake up, and then you're gonna have a different dream, and then you're gonna experience it as reality. But what we are saying here is that the more you realize that you are dreaming, and every one of us has that experience, you know, when you are in such a rush, when I'm getting anxious around something, I tend to dream that I'm missing my plane, I'm missing a train, and I get that feeling. But in those moments when you, within the dream, we realize that it's just a dream. You just go and say, how do you feel? You go and say, okay. Yeah, I could still have a sense of urgency and blah, blah, but I know that I'm okay. Why? Because I know that it's a dream. Now, some people could say, hold on. Let's be realistic. Because a dream is a dream, but reality, look, how I'm going to pay my bills. This is happening in my life. This is blah, blah, blah. These are my circumstances, so you cannot tell me that those are a dream. That's not what we are saying. We are not saying that your circumstances are a dream. We are saying, look in the direction of how you create your experience of those circumstances. We cannot experience anything directly. We can't. The only thing that we experience is coming from what we are thinking. If I'm not thinking about something in this instant, that doesn't exist in my life in this instant, right? So, my experience of the situation and the way that I'm feeling about the situation, the way that I'm feeling about myself, the way that I'm feeling about my past, it's not coming from that directly. It's coming from my thinking. It's an inner experience. Even though it's about something external, it's an inner experience. Right? And why is that so important? Because we live in a world of thought, of thoughts. Right? And as humans, we have this capacity of bring thought to life, so we feel it as real. But we don't see thought. We are so used to be in the experience of our thinking that we don't even see our thinking. We just assume that that's real. So let's take an example about something that you think is wrong with you, that you need to overcome. Is that what you are? Or is that what you think you are? Then you could have hundreds of arguments saying, no, look at this, this is what I tend to do, this is what I tend to feel, this is what I don't do, this is what I do, this is blah, blah, blah. What is all that? Arguments, ideas, beliefs, blah, blah, blah. Thoughts and thoughts and thoughts. But we are so used to see thought as the reality that we are scared of that. Because then we believe that is something real, and then we believe that is something that we need to fix. And then we start creating theories, models, techniques, blah, 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 in order to fix what? To fix a feeling, to fix a way that we see things. Basically, we are trying to fix a world of illusions. Now, many people I know, because that's the way that I used to hear this. Ah, yes, so I need to control my thinking. No, because from where are you going to try to control your thinking? From where are you going to try to manipulate your thinking? From where are you going to try to have better thinking? From your own thinking. Because it's your own thinking who's saying, ah, okay, I don't like this thought. Let's change it for this. This is the right thought to have. This is the right way to think. This is the right. And you are, what are you using to do all that? Your own thinking. you're using the same issue. It's like I give an example all the time, which is the hammer. You know, I needed to put a nail somewhere to, how do you say that, to nail a nail? I don't know how to say that. And then the hammer works really well. It did the job. It had the job done. So therefore I said, ah, this hammer is so good. I'm going to use it for everything. So we start trying to open a bottle with the hammer. We try to start the car with the hammer because, you know, it worked for this. So I'm going to use it for everything. It's a great thing. So because our thinking was a great tool, we started overusing it all the time that we don't even realize that that's what we are using to relate with the world, to relate with everything. So we use it to try to fix the thinking that we are having around ourselves from that thinking as well. You know, is that thing that Einstein said, that, you know, everyone is using this quote of Einstein that you cannot create you cannot solve a problem from the same level that you have created. And everyone says, ah, so I need, within that frame of thinking, I need a better one. No, you are using your thinking to solve it. That's what he meant in terms of, you cannot use in the same level, not because you need to fix the level, the thinking. It's because we have so much more available as human beings. But the more we get so attached to the world of ideas and concept models and blah, 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 that they are all based on the fact of let's fix the dream instead of let's wake up to the fact that you are just dreaming, right? Mm. And that's the way that we relate with everything, because we don't know that. So we relate with circumstances saying, ah, it's the circumstance that is causing me this. Because I don't see that it's my thinking about the circumstance. Right? And what we are talking about all this is an awakening, because when you awaken to something, then you know where to look for the answers.
Yeah, now, I love that. You know, it is so much simpler than what we're taught. It really is. There is a simplicity to life that we are not shown, that there is a misunderstanding around the simplicity there is around life and the way things work. And, you know, we live in a world of complexity and drama. And, you know, it's a world that our intellect loves, but it's one of the reasons why there's so much suffering in the world. And, you know, what we are saying may sound simplistic to you, but don't let the simplicity of what we're saying belie the profoundness of it. You know, the paradigm that we're pointing you towards, and, you know, and we've just started to touch the tip of the iceberg here, has profoundly impacted the way we live in the world and the work that we do. And I can honestly say that what I've seen results-wise in my own life, within my own marriage, with the relationship with my children, and the results that my clients get has been extraordinary and incomparable to anything I was doing before. Incomparable. And so, what's the word? So incredibly satisfying when, you know, if you remember when we first started the webinar here, what was it that you know, Karen and I were sharing? What was it that brought us into coaching, that desire to make a difference, that desire to help others, that desire to end suffering? the most satisfying thing I have ever done in anything that I've ever looked at, learnt before in my life. And, you know, I think one of the things that's so important here is, you know, we're talking about all the misunderstandings that are out there. And there's no blame around here. Karen and I are not putting blame on anyone. We're not trying to say people are wrong. Whatever we learned came from a good intention, all right? The intention behind what people are teaching is great. It's not that there's a wrong intention. It's just that there are so many people operating from the same misunderstanding, okay? And what happens when you start to live out of a paradigm of pushing and striving and fixing and all of those things is you think that you're operating from a solid foundation, but you kind of end up in quicksand, right? And the more you kind of struggle, the more everything feels bigger and overwhelming at times. And really what we want, what you want, what our clients want and potential clients want is solid ground, a foundation that doesn't waver, that allows us to reconnect with our own magnificence, with and the magnificence of being a human being. You know, you can tell someone that, but unless you've seen it and unless they've seen it, it just becomes something that's good to know, right? And there's a really big difference between telling someone that and someone seeing it, truly, truly seeing it. It's oceans apart, kilometers apart. Because when someone sees that, and I've seen this time and time and time again with clients, they let go of something like that in an instant. And they don't need a technique. They don't need emotions to be cleared. They don't need to go back in time and relive an experience. It shifts like that. Because that's the extraordinary power of human beings. It shifts just the same way we shift when we wake up from a nightmare and we're still in the fear of the nightmare until the realization of the fact that I'm having a nightmare hits me and it goes in a second. It's that quick and that powerful. And people never go back. Because, you know, when we are in alignment with the flow of life, when we're in alignment with our own creativity, our of inspiration, and there's a huge difference between inspiration and motivation, a huge, huge, huge difference. When you're in alignment with those things, you are able to handle, you're able to handle the curveballs, the inevitable curveballs that life throws your way, because let's face it, life is a contact sport. And you are not so afraid of life. One of the reasons there's so much psychological suffering out there is because people are afraid of life. They're afraid of their experience. And they're desperately trying to change their circumstances. They're putting the basis of their well-being into something that they don't have control over, right? And then they start to think that they need to be fixed and they need to change partners, or they need more money or a better job or a different career, or they need to change countries. And they innocently believe those things will give them the peace and well-being that they're looking for. And that paradigm will never, ever, ever give you or anyone else that sense of well-being. So, you know, the thing is, even if a client comes to you and you do a technique and they feel better, if they're still living from the paradigm that thing outside there determines my reality, can you see that it doesn't matter how many techniques they do, they're still gonna fall short at some point, because their well-being is placed in something external to them. They don't understand where their experience is coming from, right? And so they're continually going to be looking for a way to feel better, to be fixed. And they're continuously going to feel like something's missing. So I know we've done a lot of talking here, and I want to just check in for a second on how this is landing for people, where people are at, how you're going with all of this.
Or if you have any questions, or you want to
if you have any questions.
One that's for you want for us to expand or something. And I think that in the meantime, that if someone has any questions or comments, in the meantime, I would love to refer to what you were saying, Fiona, as well, in terms of even in my coaching, you know, while I was being trained and all these things, if someone would have come to me and said, look, just give something else a chance, just explore a different paradigm, just get out of that speed train of more things, more information, more techniques, more models, more deals, more complexity, whatever. Hold on, just take a break. Just take a deep breath and explore something different. What if all those things have been created from the same perspective? And I think it's something worthwhile exploring. Now, we took that chance with Fiona. We changed 180 degrees what we were doing as coaches, what we were doing as trainers of coaches, because we realized, hold on, this is not about more and more pushing, more blah, blah. What if we have the wrong map? No, but there are thousands of coaches. There are all these successful people in this that are, yeah, but what if everyone who's around this, in terms of everyone who has the same paradigm, is using the wrong map without knowing it. You know, the fact that hundreds and millions of people believe that the earth was flat didn't make the earth flat. And we have some comments, but I don't see any questions more than Mark and Rob, thank you for thanking us about all this. So I'm gonna keep going. If in any time you want to say hi or write a comment or a question, please feel more than welcome.
Fiona's saying this is resonating with her, or she's saying yes. So that's great. That's awesome. Thanks, Fiona. Appreciate that.
Okay. So. And I think that this is something quite interesting. Is I think that we have learned to calibrate something or to measure something using around our lives and around our coaching and around transformation using the wrong measurement. And what I mean by that is, in my case, I was taught that the more intelligent model, the most intelligent model was the more complex, the more complex, the more analyzed, the more, I don't know, very in depth of the blah, 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 the blah. And I remember me saying, oh my God, I need to learn all that. I need to, the step by step, I need this on how this person got into that conclusion. How is this, how is that? And I remember the feeling after that. I'm not enough, I need to learn enough. And that keep, as you were saying, Fiona, keep reinforcing, I'm not enough, I'm not smart enough, blah, 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 blah. All the same paradigm, right? Mm-hmm. And the thing is, as I was mentioning before with my example of the hammer, our intellect is a great tool, you know? It's a great tool for what? To process information. It's a great tool to storage information, not to be our GPS, not to be our compass. Because is this great that I don't have to learn every day how to use my mobile phone? I just grab it and then I just start using it. That is information that is stored. And the intellect loves that. The intellect loves certainty. Okay, they tell me the step by step. Tell me the how this works. And let me feel smart. It's like our intellect loves to feel smart, right? So when our intellect sees something that says, this is something smart, the intellect says, I need that. Oh yeah, I need that. So the intellect loves these complex things and this blah blah blah. Now, when we believe that that's our main tool to get to know how to change ourselves, to improve ourselves, blah, 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 we are using the intellect which loves to judge and say, okay, this is wrong, this is right, this is this. And what is using? Remember that it's processing information. So what is using to do all that is beliefs, is things that already learned, is things that you heard from someone, is things that you have repeated to yourself for a long time, right? And the model techniques and all that comes in the same realm. So we end up in playing so much games. But in the meantime, how we're feeling. In the meantime, what we have left out, our essence, what we really are. And that's why this sounds so interesting. The model techniques sound so interesting, and sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. Sometimes they work for the short term. Most of the time, they don't last. Why? Because they're playing in this little field. This tool that we have, which is great, but we are as human beings more than that, right? And this is the awakening that we are inviting you to look in that direction of this awakening.
Yeah, I love that, Karen. And it is. That's exactly how it felt for me. Is like an awakening from from living in a paradigm to living in a completely different paradigm. You know, it's really interesting when, you know, and I trust that you're starting to get an idea of when we talk about the different paradigms, that we're starting to see the paradigm we've been talking about around pushing models, learning, information, complexity, etc. And we're pointing you in a different direction completely. And, you know, it really is interesting in the fact that, you know, there are a lot of specialized therapists, psychologists, coaches, mental health professionals out there, you know, and they all have different things that they're really great at. You know, they've got different definitions around things, models, techniques. And what I find really interesting about that is that, you know, the more specialized we become in terms of, you know, defining ourselves, in terms of the models that we learn, in terms of the techniques that we learn, it seems to be that we end up with less well-being and mental and emotional health. I can't tell you the number of coaches who've come to me and said, my marriage is worse since I started personal development than before I began. I feel worse about myself than before I began this journey. I wish I'd never done any personal development work because I was actually happier than before. And I find that fascinating and not surprising because I could relate to exactly every single part of that. I really could. And you know, what is also interesting is, you know, when you think of how many different types of therapists, psychologists there are out there, and they all come with the best of intentions. We all have the best of intentions. This isn't a conversation around intention here. It really isn't. But what's really interesting is, you know, there's the rate of depression, suicide, and anxiety is through the roof in the world. People are not getting better. They're getting sicker. Divorce is through the roof. Marriages are not being saved. And if all of these things really truly worked, we would be seeing an impact on that. And instead, we're seeing the opposite. You know, and one of the reasons is exactly what Karen was just saying. There's an enormous missing piece here that isn't that isn't being acknowledged, that clients aren't being shown, and they're not being shown because therapists, coaches, we're not being shown because we're operating out of this paradigm innocently, right? And, you know, the biggest problem is that our intellect is just a tool. Yet it's the thing that people over-rely on, overuse, and innocently believe every single thing that they think. And most of the time what they're thinking is coming from their intellect, from their ego, from this illusion. And you know, it overcomplicates everything. Has you feel you are not enough. And you know, the more you live in that world of overcomplication, the heavier and heavier and pushier, if there's a word, such a word, that life feels. There's this constant need to strive. And when you're not striving, this guilt of, I should be doing something right now, but I can't be bothered, I don't feel like it. There is what I would say, and Karen would say, a resistance to the experience that you're having, right? And a continual resistance to the experience that you're having. And when we continually resist the experience that we are having, that is what creates psychological suffering. And this is what is happening all over the world. People are resisting their experience. They are managing themselves. They're innocently believing that that feeling good is something they've got to work towards. And if they're not doing that, then it's their fault. And most personal development programs are reinforcing this paradigm over and over and over again. Hence why for a large portion of people, and I'm not going to say for everyone, okay, because there are many people who get wonderful things out of personal development, but they have different thinking, right? And that's why. But for a large portion of people, they end up feeling worse off than before they began. Now, this begs the question, is this the way that things should be? Really, is this really how things are meant to be? Is life meant to be this hard? Or are we simply just looking in the wrong direction?
And look, this is an exploration that for us, not only can I say change our lives, but change the way that we have worked with clients. And that's still the thing, you know, if you believe in a model of pushing, how long until you get exhausted? Which was my case. Now, all these things, what we are saying, like remember that we were talking about that we wanted to share how to build a solid foundation? Because when we have these misleading things, these misunderstandings that are based on, okay, how I can manipulate the content of my dream so it's better and blah, 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 and how I'm going to use it coming from the tool of my intellect or the intellect of others. That's what we have been doing. Oh, look, this person came up with this model of this. Oh, yeah, that sounds really good. That was me. I was following everyone who had a great model. But then, hold on a second. Then I realized, okay, we have forgotten, with all those theories and models, something. We have forgotten something. What we are made of as human beings. We believe that we have to create, to control from the intellect all these things that we are. We believe that it's like what we are talking about is more than a manufacturing process, a mining one. But for a mining one, you need to stop all the distractions that make sense to the intellect. Now, hold on, because there is a point here that some people could hear this from the perspective of, okay, so this is just a world that is not practical. No. It's different when you, coming from your intellect, want to create. Hold on, Diana, your microphone is making noise because it's what is.
Oh.
Thank you. It's different when you come from the intellect and you want, it's like when you have goals, you know, it's you said, okay, I'm supposed to have this amount of money. I'm supposed to be this type of person. And then you look at it and it's like, oh my God, no, it feels horror. What we are saying is you can come from a place of clarity, of certainty, but within you, not a made up certainty. You can come from a place of inspiration. You can come from a place of creativity, a place of well-being, but not the one that you have to create from ideas. That is already inside of you. That is already inside of your client. is a mining operation, not a manufacturing one, which I think that for me was one of the biggest changes in where to look at. This is an exploration process. This is not a memorizing, analyzing thing, you know. This is around finding the solid foundations to create the life that we want, but not out of ideas, but out of what we have happening for us that we are not exploring. Believe me, we have been in all the coaching courses, technique, philosophies, blah, blah, blah. You cannot start from all these good ideas and explore them. Now, the solid foundation for personal transformation, it has to be based on principles that, and principles or laws. And what we mean by principles and laws is things that are not only undeniable, but they're unconditional. They don't change from person to person. They don't change from moment to moment. Right? Why we experience so much differences in the way that we feel, so why sometimes these techniques work, why sometimes it doesn't, because they are not based in solid foundations. What we mean by that is, if you check, for example, the logic of X technique that says, okay, if this happened to you, this is you have been hurt in this way, or this is the trauma that it has that you have, or this is the consequences that you're paying. So that's the problem. So this is the solution. So you would say, okay, that makes sense. But if that would be based on something solid, it would happen all the time, every time, to everyone. Meaning, if someone experienced this event, it would feel the same way and it would have the same effect that it has had with anyone who have experienced that event. That is not the case. But all the models and techniques would say, oh yeah, yeah, if something is that like that is happening, then this is what you need to do, this is what you need to aim for, and this is what you blah, blah, blah. But all that is coming from where? From an idea. A really clever idea that someone said, you know, this is what could be happening, and because this is happening, this is the solution. But that's not the way that human beings work. The way that human beings work respond to principles. Right? And unfortunately, we don't have enough time to explore all of them. The good news is that there are only three principles that dictate how we create our experience of life. And one of them is behind what we have been sharing with you in this webinar. We would love to have more time to explore more. But what we are talking about, how you create, how I create, how every human being creates its experience, our experience of life, that comes from inside, that comes from this capacity of thinking. That's the reflection of one of the principles that we are talking, right? When we look at the direction of, okay, if this experience happened to me, the circumstance happened to me, and I'm feeling this way, where is that experience located? It's inside of me. It's not outside. It's not in the past. The past is already gone. It's not from this situation, because the situation is a moving target. It's coming from inside. And that's where you need to explore in this direction. This is where you need this is the exploration that we are dedicating our lives with Fiona, exploring with ourselves, with the people that we are training, with the people that we are sharing this understanding around, with our clients. Because it's an awakening. Right? So if you feel that there is something here that you would like to explore, if you feel that there is something resonating, something that is creating curiosity, and just of the fact that, believe me, there is a there is an easier path. We can explore what we have happening for us as human beings, the flow of life. Instead of, and it's interesting because many of these things they are saying, look, we are focusing on the positive, not in the negative. But you are using the negative to measure what you need to do, instead of building on the positive, building over well-being, building over creativity, right? And as we were saying, this is an exploration. This is an exploration, and it's not about trying to change our thinking. It's not manipulating it from the same perspective. It's changing a paradigm. It's opening ourselves not to a better world based on what we know. It's to opening ourselves to a new world where the long-lasting transformation it is possible, you know.
Yeah, that's right. And, you know, this has been a discovering that has changed everything for us. And as I said earlier, you know, it has transformed the my marriage, my relationship with my children, and the way I work with people, and the results that my clients get, and has been the most satisfying thing I've ever done. You know, I said to Karen, before I discovered this, I felt like I was searching for something. And even though I'd done all this training, all this work, you know, there are a couple of people on the call who know me. You know that I've done, you know, I was very highly trained in NLP. I was working out of that paradigm. I really thought that that was the answer. But I had this niggling doubts because I was seeing the inconsistent results clients were getting. And once I'd started looking past, it's got to be me, what is it? It was looking in that direction. You know, once I realized, well, if it's not me, what is it, right? Looking past it, maybe I'm the problem. Once I got past that and started going, well, what is it? That's when, you know, we made this discovery and we looked in this direction and I felt like I'd finally come home and I've stopped searching. I went, there's a truth in this work that touches you deeply at your core and touches clients, no matter what the client's background is. And we knew that, you know, as I said to you earlier, I've seen that many coaches come to me, message me, say, hey, can you help me? I'm struggling. And they're struggling with the same things. And, you know, Karen and I really knew we had to share this with you. We had to give you an opportunity to discover what we've discovered, which is why we have put together something really special for you guys. And I know that looking in this direction is life-changing. And I know you've probably heard that term, or we've been told things are life-changing before. I get it. But I really didn't know what life-changing was until I saw this.
So if you're a person who dreams of creating more well-being, fulfillment, and happiness in your own life and the lives of others, we have created a step-by-step program to help you realize this dream, to guide you in this exploration, to share with you how we have transformed our own lives. Because for me, and I know that for Fiona, it's the same thing, coaching took a totally different meaning. It's not about more doing, more pushing, more discipline, more rituals, more deal. It's a transformation journey. But it's one that it could be enjoyable, it's one that it could be a flow, it's one that is an exploration. And it produced amazing practical results. This is not a woo-woo thing, you know, this is extremely practical. Where inspiration comes from, when passion comes from, it's not a manufacturing process, it's a mining exploration. So as Fiona was saying, we have creating a program that is aimed to help people, not only coaches. For me, it's a foundational program for coaches. It's like the step one for coaches, to be honest. But also for people who want to experience something different, who want to experience a life of joy, of well-being, of not pushing, more of a creation place.
And, you know, this program really is about guiding you on how to awaken from the most common paradigms. And, you know, we've talked about some of them today, which have us feeling trapped in cycles of overwhelm, hopelessness, frustration, exhaustion, anxiety, and worry, right? All the things that your clients come to you with. And that has you step into your potential so you can tap into the most powerful inner resources you have available. Stepping into your potential is not about giving you overwhelming mountains of information, having you learn models, theories, techniques. That's not what we're talking about. Mm. And really, this program's around guiding you on how to close those unresourceful loops that we unwittingly get ourselves stuck in, thanks to our conditioning, thanks to the conditioned thinking that we have.
And thanks to the overuse of the intellect. Mm. We're going to help you with your conditioning. They are based on conditioning themselves.
Mm. Yeah.
We also, this program is meant to guide you on how to awaken and reconnect with your incredible potential, your talents and unique qualities, such as inspiration, clarity, passion, energy, wisdom, and resiliency. Not something that you have to build or create or work on. It's already there. We're just looking in a different direction so far. Mm. Therefore, you can create a life of well-being, fulfillment, regardless of your past, your present, or future circumstances. Also, it's going to guide you on how to understand the necessary foundations that will allow you to inspire and facilitate transformations in others around you, because it's going to start with you.
Absolutely. And, you know, this is really on guiding you on how to stop chasing your tail with techniques, models, and theories, so you can experience flow and well-being without pushing and the exhaustion that comes from trying. And, you know, we really want to help you feel and embrace the greatness of the human spirit and rely less on your intellect. And, you know, in doing so, have you awaken and utilize the best GPS you have available, your own inner wisdom. Now, I know the term wisdom gets bandied around a lot, and lots of people put different meanings on that. But there is a law around wisdom that applies to everyone, irrespective of culture, race, age, socioeconomic conditions, religion. And when you see it, you will know how to help your clients see it. And once a client sees this, they can never unsee it, which is why someone can create change and never go back. Mm. It's extraordinarily powerful. But you have to know how to see it in yourself first in order to be able to show it to others.
Mm. So if we could summarize what the program is around, is to guide you in how to create and maintain real, long-lasting transformation in your life, which is not based on fixing, clearing, and removing emotions, memories, past, blah, blah, blah. But how to create that long-lasting transformation as the foundation that we all as coaches need to help others.
Hmm. Absolutely. So if you're a person who yearns for a rich, full life of abundance without the common limitations and unhealthy paradigms many people innocently live by. I really say innocently here. There's no judgment around this. If you're interested in understanding what real long-lasting transformation looks like and how to achieve it without all the things we're talking about, if you want to raise your level of well-being and fulfillment in your life like never before, consistently.
And if you're someone who wants to feel fulfilled with peace of mind and well-being, no matter what the circumstances, and if you want to be a source and a multiplier of well-being for others, and if you know that there has got to be more to life than what we currently see as common, this program is for you, and we would love the opportunity to share all this with you in this space.
Now, I know that this probably sounds like a lot of bold promises, and you know, you've probably been sitting in a space where lots of people fling a lot of bold promises out there, okay? Like I said at the start of the webinar, this is not a program teaching you how to make $1 million with coaching, and we're not looking in that direction around this, okay? This is giving you a completely different paradigm, right? And, you know, it can sound like we're making a lot of bold promises there. And you know, and Karen and I were discussing this earlier, that if someone had said the same to us before we know what we now knew, before we had this understanding that we want to share with you, we may have thought the same thing.
Mm.
And I'm so desperate to change the paradigm of pushing that's out there. And so is Karen. We're so committed to it. We really want people to see what's possible.
Mm.
That's why we've put this together. We're not about to push a really expensive program down your throat, guys. This is really, really, really reasonably priced. And we want you to try this risk-free. For us, this is about you guys having a chance to see what we've seen, and then you can make up your own mind about it, right? So we want you to try this risk-free, right? We want you to try the program. Check it out for yourself. Try it on. Have a look at it. Get a sense of the direction that we're pointing you in.
Right, and we're going to tell you what we mean by risk-free, because this is not about, you know, how you said it in contracts. Have you read the little letter? This is not
the fine print.
The fine print, thank you. We're going to tell you what we mean by risk-free. So we have created a program, Fiona and I, exploring all these, and the program is virtual life classes like this one, like the one we are running. You're going to have videos and downloadable audios that you can, you know, have in your phone, in your MP3, so you can study at your own pace. The material is there 24/7. We don't believe in the more is more. You know, we are not going to give you hundreds of material we are just going to give you what we have tested is the foundations of this exploration, right? So the program is about 30 plus lessons, short lessons, as we have learned, less is more, but when it's quality, right? We are going to have a private membership portal where you can keep track of your progress, of what you have been checking and exploring, and you're going to have 12 months access to the classes and the material. And the program is, the offer that we have today is one-time payment of $497, right? That is including the 30 classes, the live classes, the 12 months of membership to the program, let's say like that. And for people who wants to explore this and say, you know what? Yeah, I'm interested. I hear that there is something here for me. You just need to go to this page that I'm putting on the chat now, which is beyondthought.com.au/start, and that's where you can find the option. You can pay with credit card right away and start right away. You can find that one payment or 497. And what we mean by risk-free, no fine print. You don't have to prove us anything or anything. You just need to say, you know what, we are we didn't like the videos, we didn't like, you know, something. So you're gonna have 30 days to experience the program or the first 10 classes, whatever comes first, right? So you're going to find it on the page that it says 15 days. We were talking with Fiona. I said, look, we want to make it really easy. Just give us a chance. give us a chance to explore this, you know, 30 days to experience the program or the first 10 classes. And if you feel that it's not for you, we will happily give you your money back. We are not here, you know, to force you to. This is something that we feel is a duty for us. Look, we were there. We were experiencing all the overwhelm, frustration, disappointment of all this. Right? Now we have another option. We have the program. You can access the program. If you just say, look, I don't have the $497 at the moment. So we created an installment plan, which is 3 monthly payments of $180, which you end up paying $540. You can make your first payment today and you can start right away the program, right? And you're gonna find that option of the 3 monthly installments, the same link, beyondthought.com.au/start, which I posted on the chat as well, right?
Cool. And, you know, I think it's really important to remember, you know, why start now? Why do this now? And I guess the question really is what, you know, how much is the cost of not living from your true potential, from that place of well-being and fulfillment? You know, what is the true cost of studying and pursuing a misleading paradigm? And what happens when we don't have clarity, peace of mind, or inspiration in our lives?
Hmm.
You know, I know for me that when I didn't have that, I struggled to prioritize things. I struggled to make the decisions that were the most impactful for me and my family. I struggled to know what was the next thing in my business. And looking in this direction has transformed the way I approach all of those things.
Mm.
And, you know, I look back now on where I was. And I'm just so grateful that I've seen this. I can't even begin to describe the gratitude I have. Mm. So we really, really want you guys to be able to have the same experience. And we know that people who are on the call are people who want to also make a difference with others. And, you know, if it's one thing the world needs is less suffering.
Mm.
And so we've put some bonuses together for you.
Hmm.
So the bonuses were put together. Oh, sorry. Do you want to talk about those, Karen?
No. That it says that before we say why start now, why not? Why not if you cannot, if you are not risking anything, if you don't like it? Mm. Look, most of people here on the line, they you know us. So it's not that we are gonna take your money and run. If you don't like it, it's fine. Just why not give it a good one? Also, we are offering some bonuses because we have learned that we should reward action, right? And that's true. And we should reward trust. So what we are offering is 1 hour of one session of 1 hour with any of us, Fiona or me. And also we have created a program that is called The Secret Truth Behind Self-Esteem and Self-Confidence. Because we know that self-esteem and self-confidence is something that, you know, you don't have money, you have self-esteem issues. You haven't take action is because you don't have self-confidence. And all that is so based on the same misleading paradigm that we said we need to address that specifically in a program to help people. So we are giving that program included with the foundations of personal transformation. Right, so it's included in the same price, $497. You're gonna have that program, and we are creating 490 tips to help you to be in contact, to help you to create momentum, to inspire you, yeah, and help you to grow in all this. So the only thing that you need to do now is, you know, go to beyondthought.com.au/start. I'm gonna show you the page in a second. You just need to select your payment option. Feel free to get excited as we are. We are getting excited for the people that we're going to get in the program, that we're getting the chance to share all this with. And then you can start your program right away and keep an eye on your inbox, because that's the way that we communicate with you. Now, I'm just going to open the room for questions, if you have any questions, comments. And also, I'm going to take you to the page just to show you where you need to go and what you need to do. So this is a page, beyondthought.com.au/start. And you're going to find here the two buttons, the $497 one payment option, or the 3 monthly installments of $180. And here, as we said, we just changed this last minute. So don't worry, you're going to have 30 days to check the program or the 10 classes, whatever comes first. Here's the explanation of what we are offering, what is included in the program, why you should do it, why you shouldn't wait. This is what you're getting. 30 plus lessons, virtual life classes like this one, videos and audios downloadable that you can just take with you and start looking in the direction of a new world. As I said, it's not even a better world. It's a totally new world for you and for those of you who are coaches to have the foundation to create transformation and how to create transformation in the life of others. And that's pretty much. How about if we read some of the comments that we have, Fiona, if you want to?
Yeah, for sure.
Hold on. I'm gonna reply this to Mark. Mark, if you want, we will send you right away our bank account. If you don't want to, if you're having those issues with your credit card, it's okay. I'm just if you can type in there your email, I'll send you right away our, because that's another option. You can transfer the money, in a bank account. that's fine as well. So don't worry about it. But also, thank you, Mark. You are one of our biggest fans. I love that. Thank you.
It's nice to have one fan. Got to start somewhere.
I know that. Okay, I'm going to take this question from Anne because you didn't. And the program, look, this is not a race. Like, I would say that comfortably, you would be through the program in 2 months, you know? But this is an exploration.
Yeah, and you've got 12 months access to it, guys. So exactly. Do you know what I mean? We're not here to say, okay, well, you've got access, that's it, it's all over. You've got the 12 months, and we really encourage you to listen to the audios or watch the videos again and again. Because there's different things you're going to hear each time.
Correct. And now, Rob, the question around the coaching training that we have talked in different in our conversations as well. This is the first step for our coaching training. So this is the foundation, and that's what we call it, Foundations of Personal Transformation. This is the first step because we have learned that because the real transformational coaching is not based on scripts, techniques, and blah, blah, blah. It needs to come from inside of you. But not from a place of what you are not, what you need to improve, blah, blah, blah. Is to know in what direction to point your clients. So this is the first step. So yes, this is the beginning of for those of you who want to become coaches in based on this that we are, this understanding that we are sharing. This is the first step. And also, answering another question, another comment that we have here, is that you don't need to be a coach to do this program. This is the first step for coaches, yes, but you don't need to be a coach to do this program. This program is for
good question.
Wants to live a life of well-being and fulfillment and in flow and all that. So, yeah. Cool. I think that I reply all the questions. The other comments is like, thank you. Look, it's, thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. And
yeah, thank you.
And
for listening to what we had to say.
Correct. And I think that's pretty much it. I think that we could call it a webinar. Thank you for being here. Feel free to share this with people that you know they could benefit from this. We will certainly love what we are doing with this, and I think that this needs to be shared. So thank you for being here. Thank you, Fiona.
And if people have got any questions and they want to ask us stuff after the webinar.
Correct. Yeah, that's a good question. At the end of the page as well, you can find our email. It's coaching@beyondthought.com.au. coaching@beyondthought.com. You can send us questions if you have any
comments
yeah. or yeah, I'm gonna type. Thank you for reading that. I missed that question. Thank you. Here it is. coaching@beyondthought.com.au.
Cool.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being
here. Thank you so much, everyone.
See you soon.
See you
soon. And it'll be fantastic to share with those of you who are going to start the program now. So see you inside. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.